Hi everyone and welcome to the presentation of the ICRA paper, Model Predictive Robot Environment Interaction Control for Mobile Manipulation Tasks. My name is Maria Vittoria Minniti and this work was done in collaboration with other colleagues of the Robotic Systems Lab EDH Zurich. The motivation behind this work is to allow a mobile under-actuated robot to manipulate objects of unknown dynamic properties that we will also generically refer to as unknown environment. In general, an effective approach to control under-actuated systems is provided by Model Predictive Control or MPC, which allows to solve an optimization problem online at fast update rates. MPC is suitable to control both fully actuated and under-actuated robots. It gives the possibility to include safety constraints. However, its problem is that it is very dependent on the availability of an accurate system model. This includes a model of the robot, which in this work we supposed to be provided by accurate CAD data, and a model of the environment, which may include different doors that the robot may be required to open, or different objects that the robot may be required to carry. To mitigate this dependency, we have looked into the literature of adaptive control. Adaptive controllers can be stated in a direct form or in an indirect form according to whether the goal of the parameter's identification is oriented towards achieving the convergence of the tracking error or the estimations of the parameters in closed loop. So far, adaptive controllers have mainly considered the fixed-based, fully actuated manipulators, and they are effective to deal with model uncertainties, and thus a good candidate to be combined with a model-based approach. So let's give an outlook of the paper. The proposed method consists in augmenting our previously presented all-body MPC controller with an adaptive controller at the level of interaction with the external environment. Within the interaction control formulation, we have implemented both a model identification adaptive control scheme, or MIAC, and a model reference adaptive control scheme, or MREC, that we have combined with the all-body MPC controller. The goal is to allow an under-actuated robot, in particular a BoltBot, to balance and follow a desired and effector trajectory while interacting with a previously unmodeled object. The problem of interaction and manipulation is particularly challenging if we are considering a ball balancing system, which is always intrinsically unstable and under-actuated. In particular, this robot requires a whole-body optimal control approach to control for locomotion, manipulation, and balancing at the same time. So let's start considering how we tackle these problems and start considering our baseline, which is the MPC problem. For motion planning and control of the robot, we use an SLQ MPC solver. This solver also manages the online switching between subsystems, such as cost functions and constraints at the start of every MPC iteration. The optimization problem is set up in such a way that it includes the robot generalized positions and velocities and the effector pose. We suppose the robot to be fully torque controllable and thus system inputs are the actuation torques. Inequality constraints include joint limits and torque limits, while equality constraints include the robot full system dynamics. And this is the part where we will embed the model of the external environment. The interaction control formulation is based on the control task for the robot to follow a trajectory with its end effector while having contact with an unknown environment, for example, a door. We make the following assumptions. We suppose the contact between the end effector and the door to be rigid. We suppose the environment model to be described by a three-dimensional second-order system. We suppose that the manipulation direction is a principal direction for the mass matrix, the damping matrix, and the stiffness matrix, and that the manipulation direction is constant or slowly varying. These last assumptions allow to obtain a one-dimensional system for the environment model, which depends on the end effector position, velocity, and acceleration, as well as for parameters which are generally unknown. If we project this result in one-dimensional system along the manipulation direction, we can obtain an augmented robot environment model that we can use in the MPC model. We also add a control force at the end effector, which in its simplest form may be a PD on the end effector position. Within the interaction control formulation, we have implemented a model identification adaptive control scheme, which is based on the following procedure. We estimate the external torque acting on the robot by means of a momentum observer. This takes as input the generalized positions, velocities, and torque of the robot, and outputs the external torque in the generalized coordinates. From the external torque in the generalized coordinates, we can retrieve the estimated interaction force by using an augmented Jacobian, which contains the Jacobian of the base and the Jacobian of the end effector. Afterwards, we estimate the environment parameters by means of an impedance estimator. This is basically a Kalman filter which takes as input the interaction force and outputs the mass, damping, spring stiffness, and steady force parameters. Finally, we can provide this estimate to the MPC model, which becomes thus aware of the evolution of the environment model at the next iteration. In a second implementation, we do not update the environment model through system identification, but rather we compute a desired interaction force at the end effector according to a model reference adaptive control approach, or MRAC. Usually this name refers to a wider class of adaptive controllers. In this work, we in particular refer to a non-classical adaptive control approach which exploits the linearity in the parameters of the system model, which in this case is the environment model. The adaptive control law, together with the parameters adaptation law and the certification of the system stability, can be obtained through the use of a Lyapunov function. If we project the control law along the manipulation trajectory, we can give it as a reference to be tracked by the MPC. We have evaluated the MPC and the interaction formulation in two experimental scenarios. The first experimental scenario is a door opening test that the robot has performed with doors of different weights. The robot has performed the task under the non-adaptive baseline MPC, the MPC and the model identification adaptive control scheme, and the MPC and the model reference adaptive control scheme. As can be seen from the video, the robot under the non-adaptive MPC, the robot has the slowest response and the largest tracking error, which is larger than 20 degrees, while both the two interaction controllers obtain final tracking errors, which are smaller than 4 degrees. Similar results can be obtained with doors of different weights. In particular, under the MRAC MPC controller, the robot can fast adapt to the unknown environment due to the balance between the adaptive term and the PD term. In particular, as the time passes, the adaptive term becomes more relevant and the PD term becomes negligible. Regarding the environment estimates, the estimated damping and steady force converge to values which are proportional to the weights of the doors that have been tested. In a second scenario, the robot should lift an unknown weight of 2 kg to the desired height. Also in this case, the baseline MPC has the largest tracking error and cannot fulfill the task. The MPC and model identification adaptive controller performs worse than in the previous scenario because the momentum observer is influenced by noise and bias in the actuator torque measurements, and this leads in turn to faulty environment estimates. The MPC and MRAC controller is the one that performs best and leads to convergence of the tracking error. This leads us to the conclusion that for our target applications, an interaction controller which is designed according to a control-oriented approach is better suited than an interaction controller which is purely based on system identification. To conclude, in this work we have proposed a formulation to make a whole-body MPC controller adaptive to mobile manipulation tasks that involve robot-environment interaction. We have implemented both a model identification adaptive control scheme and a model reference adaptive control scheme, which in combination with the baseline MPC controller outperform the non-adaptive MPC in the considered manipulation tasks. The resulting method can be applied to most service robotic tasks which are typically one-dimensional, for example, for opening doors or drawers or pushing carts. Finally, we have successfully performed a door opening task and a weightlifting task with an under-actuated ball balancing robot. As future directions, we would like to remove the one-dimensionality assumption of the environment model and extend to multi-degrees of freedom tasks, for example, collaborative tasks. Also, so far, we have mainly been interested in achieving the desired closed-loop performance in practice. Providing stability guarantees for the robot under the MPC controller is an important problem that we will further pursue in future research. Finally, we would like to extend to different mobile manipulators, for example, like robots. Thanks for the attention.